of a homogeneous differential equation, x times x minus 1 times y double prime plus 3y prime minus uy is equal to 0, and you are given x equals 0 is a regular singular point, so our solution is given in this form, y equals power series from 0 to infinity in x and n plus r. Take the first and the second derivative gives me this. Then we are going to plug these into this one, but before I do that, I'm going to distribute this out. So let me draw a line here to separate these steps. So distribute this out, I have xy double prime x square y double prime minus x y double prime plus 3y prime minus 2y is equal to 0. Now we plug this into this one. So we have power series from 0 to infinity cn n plus r n plus r minus 1 x to the n plus r. So you have x to the n plus r minus 2 times x squared. So add the exponent together, which gives you this. Minus power series from 0 to infinity cn n plus r minus 1 x to the n plus r minus 1. Again, you add the exponent together, which gives you this, plus 3y prime, which is power series from 0 to infinity, 3cn n plus r, x to the n plus r, minus 1. And then minus 2y, which is power series from 0 to infinity, 2 times this, cn x to the n plus r, is equal to 0. Right? Now we are going to take a look at the power. So when n equals 0, looking 0, I have x to the r. Looking 0, I have x to the r minus 1. Looking 0, I have x to the r minus 1. Looking 0, I have x to the r. So we have to run out terms for each power series. So for the first one, so let's run out terms for this first. So let me use different color here. So run out terms for this one and this one. So for this one, looking 0, I have negative c naught. R times r minus 1 x to the r minus 1 minus power series from 1 to infinity, cn n plus r minus 1, x to the n plus r minus 1. Okay, and for this one, we are going to run our term, do the same thing we did for this one. So looking 0, I have c naught, 3 c naught, r times x to the r minus 1, plus power series from 1 to infinity, 3 cn n plus r, x to the n plus r minus 1. Now for this one, and this one, we already rewrite it because we need x to the r, okay? But if you notice, so I look one step ahead, so I know that I have to win this. I have to run out term and I got n equals 1. So that's why I leave this blank. I ignore this at first. And then now I'm able to reindex this to 1, okay? And do the same thing for this one, reindex this to 1 to match with these. So reindex this to 1, I have power series from 1 to infinity, cn minus 1. N plus r minus 1, n plus r, n plus r minus 2, x to the n plus r minus 1, okay? And for this one, we are going to do the same thing, reindex it to 1. So we have power series from 1 to infinity, 2 cn minus 1, x to the n plus r minus 1, and they are equal 0, right? Now we are going to combine like terms. So for this one, we have c naught r in common. So factor it out. Oops. C naught r. And in parentheses, I have distributed the negative sign. So I have negative r plus 1 plus 3, which gives me negative r plus 4 times x to the r minus 1 plus power series from 1 to infinity. Okay. And they are multiplied by x to the n plus r minus 1. So I just factor it out and put it at the end. Okay. So in parentheses, I have c. So I have this one, cn n plus r in common, factor it out. Then I left with, so don't forget to distribute the negative sign in front, so I have negative n minus r, plus 1, plus 3, which is positive 4. Right? And this one, cn minus 1, cn minus 1 in common, factor it out. And in parentheses, we have n plus r minus 1 times n plus r minus 2, minus 2. So we have n plus r minus 1 times n plus r minus 2, and then minus 2. Okay, do I just squeeze everything into the little space that I created? Alright. Now we're going to equate coefficient. So we have c naught r times negative r plus 4 equals 0, and set everything inside the bracket equals 0. So cn n plus r negative n minus r plus 4 plus cn minus 1 n plus r minus 1 n plus r minus 2 minus 2 equals 0. So this is our system of equations. And I'm going to solve for r, so I have r equals 0 and 4. This is my R values, okay? And for each value, we are going to plug it into this one and then solve for Y solution. So let's take a look at the first case when R equals 0. So when R equals 0, plugging 0 into this one, we have C in times negative n plus 4 plus C in minus 1. In minus 1, in minus 2 equals 0. Then solve for the biggest C, which is C in. Then I have negative C in minus 1. So I'm going to distribute this out. So I have n times n, which is n squared, minus 2 in, minus 3 in, plus 2, minus 2, all over n times negative n plus 4. So simplify this a little bit. We have n squared minus 3 in. Let me move this up. So we have n squared minus 3 in, factor out n, and simplify with the n on the bottom. So what I have left is negative c in minus 1 times n minus 3 all over negative n plus 4. And n is starting from 1 to infinity. Okay? And here's the thing. So when n equals 4, you will get an issue because you divide by 0. But how to fix it? So for n equals 4, you are going to plug it into the original equation, which is this one, okay? And then solve for the unknown, solve for the biggest C, okay? And then for the other term, for the other numbers, you just plug into this one, because for n equals 4, if you plug into this one, it will make this undetermined, so you have to plug into this one. That's the thing. Only one exception for that, okay? So when n equals 1, plugging 1, I have C1 equals, so plugging 1 have 1 minus 3, negative 2, positive 2, C0, over 3. When n equals 2, I have C2 equals positive 1, C1 over 2, and C1 is this, so I have C0 over 3, okay, and my Y1 is equal to x to the r, which is 0, C0 plus C1, x, which is 2 C0 over 3, x plus C3, which is C0 over 3, L x squared plus dot dot dot, and then factor out C0. So we have in parentheses is 1 plus 2/3 x plus 1/3 x squared plus dot dot dot, right? Now we are going to do the same thing for r equals 4, okay? So I'm gonna do it real quickly here. So our final solution is equal to y1 plus y2, and my y1 is this. So this is my y1, and down here is my y2. So, and keep in mind that these C0 are not the same. So for this one, I'll call it C1, and for this one, I'll call it C2. So I have C1 times 1 plus 2/3 x plus 1/3 x squared plus dot dot dot, and for this one, I'm gonna call it C2. So, in parentheses, it's the same. Just rewrite it, okay? Alright, so this is my final solution. That's it. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.